Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech and iOS 17.2 Beta 3 release today to developers, and iOS 17.2 Public Beta 3 should be out by the time you're watching this video, or sometime tomorrow. Now if you want to jump right into the features or any other part of this video, be sure to check out the chapters linked in the description. Now along with this, Apple also released iPadOS 17.2 Beta 3, watchOS 10.2 Beta 3, along with visionOS Beta 6, and many others like they typically release. This particular update came in at 650.1 megabytes, that's on my 15 Pro Max, and was about the same size on all the devices, up to about 800 megabytes or so. Now let's go ahead and talk about the build number and take a look at what's new. So we'll go into Settings, General, then About. As you can see, the build number is 21C5046C, and as we get closer to a final release, that letter at the end will change to an A, just like it is on visionOS Beta 6. Then we'll get an RC and a final release. We'll talk about when to expect that later today, but we do have a modem update in Beta 3, so hopefully that again continues to help with overall connectivity. Maybe there's some changes there. As far as new features, well, the first one is something they've brought back. If we go into our wallpaper, when you're adding a new wallpaper, you'll see under Collections that we now have live wallpaper that's returned. So it's actually here in motion, like you would expect, just like before, and they finally brought that back. It will start to move in the background and move as you move your phone around like that. So it's a nice little update there, and then you can change it to light or dark mode. If we go into our settings and then we go to General and then Keyboard, there's a new option here for show predictions in line. So many of you that don't want this option, we now can turn this off. So as you're typing, it will show predictions while you're typing, and you can hit space to actually accept that prediction or not at all. If you don't like that, you can now toggle it off. Back within settings, if we scroll down to music, we actually have a new option here for add favorite songs. They've added this for your library, and you'll see here on beta 2 on the left, it's not there, where we just have add playlist songs. And it actually says add songs to your library when you add them to your playlists or you favorite them. So you can disable that now if you'd like to. Additionally, if we go into music, we have a new splash screen that pops up the first time we go in, where it says, "Welcome to Apple Music. Play millions of songs," and it's just telling you about it in general. Tap continue, and then you're into your music. Now, the first time you open the Photos app, you'll also have a new pop-up that asks for access. It says, "Photos would like to access Apple Music, your music and video activity, and your media library. Photos can use Apple Music to curate songs for memories." So if you want to allow that, you can, or you don't have to allow that, and you could select your music manually in the memories options. So that's something they've updated there as well. Also, some people are seeing a new splash screen the first time they go into the journaling app. So let's see if we get that here. Go into Journal. You'll see it says, "Welcome to Journal. Write about your day and add photos, places, and more." And then lock your journal to keep it private. So there seems to be a new splash screen for that as well. Within Safari, if we go into Safari and then you go to your bookmarks and then you go to your history and tap clear, if you select last hour, today, or any of these clear time frame options, this will actually now stay and remember it the next time you go into it. So if we want today and yesterday, we clear that. Next time we go in, let's do that. We've cleared it. It actually remembers it here. So if we go back into it and maybe go to Apple again, then we'll go to learn more, go back to our bookmarks, then go to clear. It actually remembers the last one you've checked. Just a nice little use case update that makes it easier. Also, some people are seeing updated video players. I'm not seeing this myself, but it's on my Telegram channel. And as you can see here, when you go to play something, it may ask you to start from beginning or have details, where before it just sort of looks like this for me. However, these buttons were new in beta 2 with info and up next. And if we go back into settings and then we scroll down to where it says phone messages and FaceTime, under phone and FaceTime, there's a new option. Within FaceTime, you'll see it says share name and photo, and we have the option for contacts only. Go into that and we can switch it from contacts only to always ask. This same exact option is there under the phone options also. So if we go back under phone, you'll see again, it's also there under phone. So the same contact card menu and everything. Additionally, to go along with FaceTime, if you're on a call, according to Aaron P613 within the code, it says it will warn you if a blocked contact is joining the call. Also, you might be able to actually collaborate via notes using AirDrop. So currently you can send someone a note using AirDrop, but you may not be able to use that collaboration tool yet. In future updates, or possibly this one, I wasn't able to get it to work. You can actually share via AirDrop and then collaborate with someone, but I don't have a phone that's on a different contact that was actually updated at the time. So let me know if that's working for you, if you've tried it. Now, as far as the release notes, if we go to Apple's public facing website, they actually haven't updated the feedback app yet, at least at the time of me filming this. So if we go in and refresh, it hasn't been updated yet with beta 3. So if we go back to the public facing website, go to view release notes, you can see the release notes here where they're updated. Not a ton that's new here, but there's some known issues that remain, such as sending an AirDrop or using NameDrop to an iOS 17.0 or 17.1 device might fail sporadically. There's also known issues with the favorite songs playlists and other things as well. Not a ton of known issues, but there's some resolved issues as well, such as after verifying a contact, the verification checkmark might not show up in messages. That's using the contact key verification. So lots of things that they continue to work on. And of course, if this is relevant to you, be sure to check it out, especially if you're a developer. I'll link that in the description. And as far as remaining bugs, well, there's definitely a few still here. One of them in particular is the wallpaper dimming bug. So if you notice how vibrant it is here, if I scroll home, it dims. So you'll see that again. Let me try that one more time. If I scroll home, it dims again once I do that, once I get rid of the notifications. Additionally, notifications seem to jump in still. Definitely still an issue there. And so there's some odd issues going on still with this. Now, as far as other issues that are going on, well, the missing keyboard and spotlight search seems to be working properly here. So no issues there. Seems to be popping up every time. I haven't seen that again, but it was definitely a bug in beta 2, and hopefully it doesn't return. But we'll have to check that in a few days in the follow-up video on the weekend to see if that returns. Last time they fixed an issue using the personal hotspot with an Android phone, so we'll have to see if they continue to resolve issues. Now, I did mention in a separate video yesterday about iOS 18, and it's apparently going to get a big redesign. So hopefully we see some big changes just like we do here. If we go back, if we go into some of the new UI here, not standby, but rather the action button, this is completely different and unlike anything we typically see on iOS. So iOS 18 could get a big update with a redesign and more. Hopefully they add more depth and flat design is done, but we'll have to wait and see. That won't be until June typically till we see beta 1 though, so it's a ways away. Now, if you're wondering if you should install iOS 17.2 beta 3, well, if you're already on beta 1 or beta 2, absolutely. But if you're wanting to try it out, typically by beta 3, it's much more stable. I would not install it if you're trying to resolve bugs though, as betas are typically buggy and you typically need to report feedback on them. So if you're wanting to be on a stable version, stay where you are. Otherwise, if you have a backup and you have a computer in case you need to downgrade, then I would definitely try it out once the public beta is out. Unless you're a developer, of course. Now, as far as iOS 17.2 beta 4, it looks like we're on a weekly schedule at this point. So we could expect that as soon as next Tuesday, maybe with the RC sometime at the end of the month, or beta 5, with a public release probably around the 13th or maybe the 11th. That's what Apple did last year. We had it on the 13th, so we could see that sort of rollout. In between now and then, it's possible we could see an iOS 17.1.2, maybe to resolve Wi-Fi issues people are having, but we don't really know. We don't see any hint of that just yet. Maybe we'll have that, maybe we won't, but either way, we should expect a lot fixed as well as additional features with the journal app and more in this update with iOS 17.2. As far as overall performance, well, a few people on Telegram and other places have already said it seems to feel very fast, and I'll show you benchmarks in a moment, but overall it feels very smooth. I've had no issues with it, just testing it over the past hour or so, going into things such as settings, scrolling around. I'm not seeing any stuttering or anything slowing down, so this is a good sign. I haven't noticed that at all. As far as overall heat, well, it was warm when I first started it up, but that's to be expected after it installs an update. Now it's nice and cool. It's really not an issue. And of course, we'll test that in a few days. Along with battery, we'll see how it is after a few days. But as far as my current battery, let's take a look. We'll go to general and check the actual cycle count under about. And as you can see, I have 43 cycles currently, so not too bad since using it new. And since it actually released a few months ago now, if we go into battery health and charging, we're at 100%. And then over the last 10 days, it has been getting me through a day, but you'll see it only shows 2.5 hours of screen active time. The day before, 2 hours and 33 minutes of screen active time, 2 hours and 3 minutes of screen idle time, and used 75% of my battery. So standby mode will definitely affect track this, as you can see the day before, if you have standby active, it shows 10 hours active. So if you have it on a nightstand with the screen on, it's counting that. So maybe they've updated this, but 2.5 hours doesn't seem right, as I'm getting through an entire day and I'm typically at about 40 to 50% at the end of the day, maybe down to 30, depending on use, but I usually don't have to charge it anymore throughout the day. So I don't think this is accurate, but hopefully they update this and provide more accuracy with it. As far as benchmarks, it actually scored pretty well. If we go into Geekbench 6, you'll see single core was 2,902, multi-core was 7,230. If we take a look at the overall history, you'll see here before, pretty close to what we had on the weekend with iOS 17.2 beta 3 after running it for a couple of weeks, pretty similar. 10 points off for multi-core and about 20 points off for single core. So not bad at all. And if we run this again, it definitely could bump up a little bit more. So overall, expect the overall performance, the way it works and everything else to be identical. As far as anything else, well, that's all we found so far. If I find anything else, of course, I'll let you know in the weekend follow-up video. And if you've found anything else, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.